Dear students, today we will begin Chapter 4 of Class 11 Business Studies, that is Business Services. For a layman, services are essentially intangibles. Their purchase does not result in the ownership of anything physical. For example, you can only seek advice from the doctor, you cannot purchase him. Services are all those economic activities that are intangible and imply an interaction to be realized between the service provider and the consumer. Services are those separately identifiable, essentially intangible wants and not necessarily linked to the sale of a product or another service. Is a physical product capable of being delivered to a purchaser? An invoice is the transfer of ownership from the seller to the customer. Now, what is the nature of services? There are five basic features of services. These are intangibility. It means services are intangible. That is, they cannot be touched. They are experimental in nature. One cannot taste a doctor's treatment or touch entertainment. One can only experience it. An important implication of this is that quality of the offer can often not be determined before consumption and therefore purchase. The second important characteristic of services is inconsistency. Since there is no standard tangible product, services have to be performed exclusively each time. Different customers have different demands and expectations. Service providers need to have an opportunity to alter their offer to closely meet the requirements of the customers. Third feature, inseparability. This is an important characteristic of service and simultaneously activity of production and consumption are being performed. This makes the production and consumption of services seem to be inseparable. While we can manufacture today and can sell it after say a month, this is not possible with services that have to be consumed as and when they are produced. Next feature is inventory-less. Services have little or no tangible components and therefore cannot be stored for a future use. Example, services are perishable and providers can at best store some associated goods but not the service itself. This means that the demand and supply needs to be managed as the service has to be performed as and when the customer asks for it. They cannot be performed earlier to be consumed at a later date. For example, a railway ticket can be stored but the railway journey will be experienced only when the railways provide it. Involvement. One of the most important characteristic of services is the participation of the customer in the service delivery process. A customer has the opportunity to get the service provided. Difference between services and goods. Service is an activity or a process. Example, watching a movie in a cinema hall. Whereas goods are physical objects, example, video cassette of movie. Services are heterogeneous, but goods are homogeneous. Services are intangible, example, doctor treatment, whereas goods are tangible, example, medicine. Simultaneous production and consumption. Example, eating ice cream in a restaurant. But separation of production and consumption. Example, purchasing ice cream from a store cannot be kept in stock. Example, experience of a train journey, whereas goods can be kept in stock. Example, train journey ticket. Now we come to the next topic, that is types of services. First of all, business services. These are those services which are used by business enterprises for the conduct of their activities. Example, banking, insurance, transportation, warehousing, and communication services. Second type of services, social service. Social services are those services that are generally provided voluntarily in pursuit of certain goals. These social goals may be to improve the standard of living of weaker sections of the society, to provide health care, hygienic conditions in slum areas. These services are generally provided voluntarily, but for some consideration to cover their costs. For example, health care and education services provided by certain non-government organizations, NGOs, and government agencies. Third type of services are personal services. These are those services which are experienced differently by different customers. These services are not consistent in nature. They will differ depending upon the service provider. They will also depend upon the customer's preference and demands. For example, tourism, recreational services, restaurants. In the context of better understanding of the business world, we will be limiting our further discussions to the first category of the service sector, that is business services. Friends, today's world is of tough competition, where the survival of the fittest is the rule. There is no room for non-performance. Hence, companies tend to stick to what they can do best. In order to be competitive, business enterprises are becoming more and more dependent on specialized business services. Business enterprises look forward towards banks for availability of funds. Insurance companies for getting their plant, machinery, goods, etc. insured. Transport companies for transporting raw material and finished goods. And telecom and postal services for being in touch with their vendors, suppliers, and customers. India has been gaining a highly competitive edge over other countries when it comes to providing services to the developed economies of the world. Many foreign companies are looking to India for performing a host of business services. First of all, banking. Commercial banks are an important institution of the economy for providing institutional credit to its customers. A bank stimulates economic activity in the market by lending money. A bank stimulates economic activity in the market by dealing in money. It mobilizes savings of the people and makes funds available to businesses for financing their capital and revenue expenditure. It deals in financial instruments and provides services for a price. Example, interest, discount, commission, etc. Now we will discuss the types of banks that are there. First of all, commercial bank. Second, cooperative banks. Third, specialized banks. And fourth, central bank. We'll discuss the first one, commercial banks. These are institutions dealing in money. These are governed by Indian Banking Regulation Act 1949, and according to it, banking means accepting deposits of money from the public for the purpose of lending or investment. There are two types of commercial banks, public sector and private sector banks. Public sector banks are those in which the government has a majority stake and they usually need to emphasize on social objectives than on profitability. Private sector banks are owned, managed, and controlled by private promoters and they are free to operate as per market forces. There are a number of public sector banks like SBI, PNB, IOB, etc. and other private banks represented by HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank and Jammu and Kashmir Bank. Cooperative banks. Cooperative banks are governed by the provisions of the State Cooperative Societies Act and are meant essentially for providing cheap credit to their members. It is an important source of rural credit, example, agricultural financing in India. Third, banks are specialized banks. Specialized banks are foreign exchange banks, industrial banks, development banks, import-export banks, catering to special needs of these unique activities. These banks provide financial aid to industries, heavy trunky projects and foreign trade. Last and the most important is the central bank. The central bank of any country supervises, controls and regulates the activities of all the commercial banks of that country. It also acts as a government bank. It controls and coordinates currency and credit policies of any country. It also acts as a government banker. It controls and coordinates currency and credit policies of any country. The Reserve Bank of India is the central bank of our country. Functions of commercial banks. Banks provide a variety of functions. Some are basic or primary functions of a bank, while others are agency or general utility services in nature. First, acceptance of deposits. Deposits are the basis of the loan operations, since banks are both borrowers and lenders of money. As borrowers, they pay interest, and as lenders, they grant loans and get interest. These deposits are generally taken through current accounts, saving accounts and fixed accounts. Current account deposits can be withdrawn to the extent of the balance at any time. Banks pay rate of interest as decided by RBI on these deposits. Fixed accounts are term deposits with higher rate of interest compared to the saving accounts. Second important function of banks is lending of funds. The major activity of commercial banks is to provide advances out of money received through deposits. These advances can be made in the form of overdrafts, cash credits, discounting trade bills, term loans, consumer credits and other miscellaneous advances. The funds lent out by banks contribute a great deal to the industry, transport and other business activities. Another important function of bank is check facility. Banks render a very important service to the customers by collecting their drawn checks on other banks. The check is the most developed credit instrument, a unique feature and function of banks for the withdrawal of deposits. It is the most developed credit instrument, a unique feature and function of banks for the withdrawal of deposits. It is the most convenient and inexpensive medium of exchange. There are two types of checks, bearer checks, which are encashable immediately at the bank counters, and cross checks, which are to be deposited only in the payee's account. Third important function that bank does is remittance of funds. Another salient feature of commercial banks of providing the facility of fund transfer from one place to another on account of interconnectivity of branches. The transfer of funds is administered by using bank drafts, pay orders, mail transfers on nominal admission charges. The bank issues drafts for the amount on its own branches at other places or other banks at those places. The payee can present the draft on the drawee bank at his place and collect the amount. Allied services. In addition to above functions, banks also provide allied services such as bill payments, locker facility, underwriting services. They also perform other services like buying and selling of shares and debentures on instructions, and other personal services like payment of insurance premium, collection of dividend, etc. Students, let us revise what we have discussed in this session. First of all, we discussed what are services, what are the special features of services, what is the difference between a goods and services. Then, what are the various types of services that are being used in the society? After discussing the various types of services, we came to business services. And amongst the business services, we discussed banking services, how important banks are in our society to carry on the business. What are the major functions that the banks do to help the business flourish in the economy? Now, students, let us test our knowledge of what we have discussed in the chapter. First question, which of the following accounts does not carry any interest? A. Fixed deposit, B. Recurring deposit, C. Specialized bank, or fourth, current account. The answer is current account. Second question, the functions of commercial banks include acceptance of deposits, B. Granting of loans, C. Locker facilities, or D. All of the above. The answer is again D. All of the above. Third question, the authority to issue currency notes rests with A. Central Bank of India, B. State Bank of India, C. Reserve Bank of India, or D. All of the above. The answer is C. Reserve Bank of India. With this, we conclude today's discussion. In the next session, we will study about a new style of banking, as well as we will discuss other types of business services. Thank you.